Welcome to LWM channel. Subscribe to our LWM channel to learn computer networking. From now on, new videos will be uploaded regularly on our channel. Today's agenda. What is Ethernet? History of Ethernet protocol? How does Ethernet protocol work? Key components of Ethernet? Types of Ethernet? Benefit of Ethernet connection? What is Ethernet? We know that Ethernet is a MAC protocol. Another way we say that Ethernet is primarily a standard communication protocol used to create local area networks. It transmits and receives data through cables. While at the Xerox Palo Alto Research Center, Bob Metcalfe wrote a memo detailing the system he had created for interconnecting computer workstations. Metcalfe's system, which would become Ethernet. In 1973, Metcalfe changed the name Alto Aloha Network to Ethernet. He did this to make it clear that the system he had created would support any computer, not just Altos. He chose the name based on the word ether as a way of describing an essential feature of the system, the physical medium carrying bits to stations. History of Ethernet protocol. At first networking initiative that started in 1968 at the University of Hawaii. After that, Metcalfe built Ethernet based on the Aloha system. Ethernet was created in early 1970 at the Xerox Palo Alto Research Center. PARC, by a group that included David Boggs and Robert Metcalfe. But Metcalfe determined in 1973 that the technology had surpassed its initial appellation, Alto Aloha Network, and will be rebranded as Ethernet. Metcalfe developed the idea of Ethernet in a document he wrote for Xerox in 1973, marking the beginning of Ethernet's development. At that time, Ethernet protocol used 2.94 Mbits over a coaxial cable, coax, using bus topology. One byte means 8 bits were used to node addresses unique only to individual networks. In 1983, the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, IEEE, ratified it as a standard, that is IEEE 802.3 for 10^5/10 Mbits over thick coax based on the CSMA/CD process. Metcalfe and Boggs, together with their colleagues at Xerox, Charles Thacker and Butler Lamson, would successfully trademark Ethernet technology 4 years later. In 1980, Xerox collaborated with Digital Equipment Corporation and Intel to create the first 10 megabits per second Ethernet standard. In the meantime, the IEEE Local and Metropolitan Area Network Standards Committee set out to produce an equivalent open standard, that is 802.3. The Landman Committee established an Ethernet subcommittee with the designation 802.3. The IEEE adopted the first 802.3 standards for thick Ethernet in 1983 and was published formally in 1985. How does Ethernet protocol work? The Ethernet protocol works as a star topology or linear bus, which is the basis for the IEEE 802.3 standard. In the OSI network structure, this protocol works both the physical layer and the data link layer. Ethernet divides the data connection layer into two distinct layers. One is the logical link control tier, and another is the medium access control, MAC, tier. The data connection layer in a network system is primarily concerned with transmitting data packets from one node to the other. Ethernet works an access mechanism known as carrier sense multiple access collision detection to enable each computer to listen to the connection before delivering data across the network. Ethernet also transmits data using two components, packets and frames. The frame contains the sent data payload as well as the following. Both the MAC and physical addresses of the sender and recipient, and error correction data for identifying transmission faults, information on virtual LAN tagging, as well as the quality of service, Each frame is encapsulated in packets that comprise many bytes of data to set up the connection and identify the frame's commencement point. Key components of Ethernet: Ethernet protocol, Ethernet port, Ethernet network adapter, and Ethernet cable. The Ethernet protocol. This protocol was developed in the 1970s by Xerox. It is a series of standards that governs how data is sent between Ethernet components as explained before. The Ethernet port. Ethernet ports, commonly known as jacks or sockets, are opening on computer network infrastructure into which one may plug in Ethernet cables. It supports cables with RJ45 connectors. The Ethernet port of a computer is linked to an Ethernet network adapter, also known as an Ethernet card, mounted on the motherboard. Ethernet network adapter. An Ethernet adapter is a chip or card that fits into a slot on the motherboard and allows a computer to connect to a local area network. In the past, these were always used with desktop computers. But now Ethernet is integrated into the chipsets of laptop and desktop motherboards. An Ethernet cable. Ethernet cable, often known as a network cable, links your computer to a router or network switch. The Ethernet cable build of the RJ45 connector, the internal cabling, and a plastic jacket. Types of Ethernet. There are many types of Ethernet connections, some of them described below. Coaxial cables based Ethernet connection. A coaxial cable transmits electrical signals at high frequencies with minimal loss. Ethernet types 10Base2 and 10Base5 are now used. This Ethernet type can be further classified into networks that use one of the following cable types: triaxial, RG6, and hardline. Fiber optic cables based Ethernet connection. These connections work optical fibers with glass cores wrapped by several sheets of cladding material. This Ethernet type may also be subdivided into networks using the following: single mode fiber and multimode fiber. Twisted pair cables based Ethernet connections. Twisted pair is a copper wire cable consisting of two insulated copper wires wrapped around to prevent interference and crosstalk. This Ethernet type may be among the following variations: shielded twisted pair, STP, and unshielded twisted pair, UTP, cables. And other fast Ethernet, gigabit Ethernet, and 10 gigabit Ethernet types of Ethernet connections. Benefit of Ethernet connection. Enforces greater security. Offers high bandwidth connections. Improves consumer internet experiences. Amplifies the capabilities of your Wi-Fi network. Supports direct current, DC, power transmission. Strikes a balance between cost and performance. Provides different options of speed based on budget, region, and requirement. Thank you very much for watching carefully.